Hello and welcome to another inorganic chemistry lesson. This time we'll discuss how to write synthesis reaction between two compounds. Before going further, you should be able to differentiate basic and acidic oxides. If you are not familiar with this topic, I suggest watching one of my videos about inorganic chemistry classification. Let's write some examples. In the first example, we have a reaction between basic oxide Na2O and acidic oxide CO2. Now, what is the product of this reaction? Well, in chemical reactions, acidic oxides always transform into specific ions. I have a table down here with acidic oxides, and it shows what ions they transform into during chemical reaction. If we find CO2, we will see that in the chemical reaction, it should change into CO3-minus ion. Let's get back to our actual reaction. So now we know that when this reaction occurs, CO3-minus ion forms. Also, that same ion will always combine with the first element from another compound. In our case, it's sodium. So our product should be NaCO3. Na is plus, CO3 is 2 minus, so our chemical formula is Na2CO3. We don't need to balance the chemical reaction because we have the equal amount of the same atoms on the both sides of the reaction. If you have a hard time understanding elements' oxidation state, compound names, or how to balance chemical reactions, I'll leave a link in the description for all these lessons. In the next example, we have a water reaction with N2O5. Once again, we have acidic oxide, so we must look at the table to find out into which ion N2O5 transforms. As we can see, it is NO3- ion. Also, as I stated before, it will always combine with the first element from another compound, which is hydrogen. So we get HNO3. H is plus, NO3 minus, and because the charges cancel each other out, our formula is HNO3. All that's left is to balance the reaction, and we can do it by writing 2 in front of HNO3. What happens if aluminum oxide reacts with sulfur 6 oxide? Well, sulfur 6 oxide must transform into an ion because it is an acidic oxide. In our table, we can see that SO3 always becomes SO4-minus after the reaction. And sulfate ion combines with aluminum because it is the first element in the compound. We get Al3+ and SO4-minus. Don't forget to swap charges with subscripts, and we get Al2SO4 × 3. To balance the equation, we write 3 in front of SO3, because after the reaction, we have 3 sulfur atoms. And now the reaction is completed. Another example is a reaction between water and basic calcium oxide. In this reaction, water always forms OH- ions, which combine with the first element in the oxide. So we get Ca2+ and OH-. The chemical formula for this compound is CaOH × 2. If we look closely, we will see that we don't need to balance this equation. Our last example is a reaction between sodium oxide and water. Once again, water transforms into OH- ions and forms a compound with sodium. We get Na+ and OH-. So the chemical formula is NaOH. To balance the equation, we write coefficient 2 in front of sodium hydroxide. And now the reaction is completed. And that's it for today's lesson. Thank you for watching. And please subscribe to this channel for more chemistry content. Like always, I leave a few exercises with answers that you can do on your own, and see you in the next lesson.